Dr. Adam, welcome. Welcome from Indonesia.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Malcolm Bethondi, sir. Thank you, everyone. My name is Adam. Yes. Please, I'm going to share screen, sir. Can you see my screen?
Yes, wonderful.
Yes.
Please make it large.
Okay, sir. PLT, transforaminal result of first 50 cases. This is endoscopic fellowship experience in Mahatma Gandhi Mission Hospital in Navi Mumbai. It's just last year. I am a young spine surgeon. I am beginner here. I started just 50 cases for the PLT transforaminal. So for a beginner here, it is okay to start a surgery or endoscopic spine. I think most of the beginner, if we see the presentation from the master, we feel like a small guys, but it is okay that we can start from beginning. This is my teacher and my I have a spine consultant in Universitas Indonesia and from Gajah Mada. I have spine fellowship at the SNUH South Korea 2006-17 and endoscopic spine fellowship. And this is all my assistant, Dr. Francisco Kani, Dr. Gore, Dr. Malcolm, Dr. Kang Tek Lim, Dr. Lutfi Katam, Dr. Harmantia, and Dr. Ichab. And also this is my Dr. Saifal and Dr. Nilesh. Okay. Sorry. Just glitch here. So this is a low back pain. Sorry. There's a problem in my computer.
Take your time, be gentle. We are not in a hurry.
Okay. There is a low back pain. I cannot go in a screen because there is error. So I go with this mode.
No problem.
So ahead. What is low back pain? We have a 80% normal population experience low back pain during their lifetime. Pain may persist for 6 weeks and major impact to socioeconomic condition. I'm going to tell this to my fellow here that not all the cases we have a bulging disc or herniated disc should undergo for endoscopic surgery. We have to select all the patient. And the lumbar disc herniation, it is a basic sciences that we have to treat the patient from the non-interventional or conservative phase first. So if I already operated approximately 50 cases, it means that it is only 10%. So I already treated 500 patients. Which one is better, getting better with bed rest, anxiety, and muscle relaxation. But if the 10% is not getting well, we can do interventional. For interventional, there are types presented before. We have a laminectomy, discectomy, and also YES system, TESIS system, interlaminar approach, foraminoscopic approach. And it is stated by Kim et al. At 2011 and Destandu at 2002. And then now we are facing a PALD. And from Kondo et al., it is the laminectomy and partial facetectomy will lead to postoperative instability, will need fusion, and transdural approach has an invasive and lengthy operation. It is cause more complication. So we are moving toward the new technology called PLT, which from the literature, it is getting spread and more studies from the 2016. There are three types of PLT. There are operative, interlaminar, transforaminal, and posterolateral. This is the study that inspired me to do the report. This is by Kandila Mahesa. This is the result of first 100 cases. I'm half of it. I just do the 50 cases. From the study, we can learn that the age of the problem of the prolapse intervertebral disc is approximately age of 40 years old, with range of 15 to 84, a male more than female, and most of them at the level like 50 L4-5 and L5-S1. And operative duration, it is 3 hours to 15 minutes. In my experience, I start with 3 hours also, and getting shorter when I did more cases. And I didn't believe at time that I believe that transforaminal can do all the kind of cases, but until my 50 cases, I have to convert also to interlaminar and also combination. So there is no one technique that superior to all approach. We have to master all of the approach of the endoscopic. And duration of hospitalization is 1.6 days and recurrence of 2 patients. The FAST score is reducing from 8 to 1, and we can see the MACNAP criteria is also good. The second journal that inspired us is simultaneous L4-5 transforaminal and L5-S1 interlaminar percutaneous endoscopic lumbar discectomy. So even we in the hand of in the heaven as expert, sometimes we have to convert and do the other approach to tackle the problem. My teacher, Dr. Makom Pestonji, has always told me that do not make the patient in harm and risk the patient with your ego to do the kind of one approach, and you will end up with injured the patient. Primum non nocere, first do no harm to the patient. It is okay that we can say to the patient, sorry, because of my lack of experience, I cannot tackle you. I endanger your nerve, so I have to convert to open. So it is my cases, my experience also. From this journal, we can see that they use both transforaminal and interlaminar. And the third, there is a study also, comparison of percutaneous endoscopic lumbar discectomy and open lumbar surgery for adjacent segment degeneration. This study is telling us that in group A who underwent PLT and open lumbar surgery, we can see the operating time become 3 times higher and the blood loss is more. So the admission day is more. So the minimal invasive surgery, I think it is a must for young surgeon actually who have more time to learn. So it is not late to start. If you are from Indonesia or anyone else, I am okay to share my knowledge with you all. And this is the microendoscopic discectomy versus PALT from this study. It is stated that PLT more fluoroscopy time and more time, but the hemorrhage here, you can see the hemorrhage is less and the post-operative bed stay is less and also the total hospital stay. I mean, it is okay to master MED, but if you willing to study PLT, we can shorten the post-operative bed stay and also hemorrhage of the patients. And the significant pitfall of percutaneous endoscopic lumbar discectomy for last central lumbar disc herniation. Why I take this journal? Because when you start doing a transforaminal, there will be problem in tackling large central lumbar disc herniation. I will show you my cases that I did problem in a transforaminal in a large central lumbar disc. So I have to add interlaminar approach also. And this is a percutaneous endoscopic lumbar discectomy for lumbar disc herniation SD surgery, a short-term clinical result of 235 consecutive cases. This is from China. As in this study, you can see the PALT, which is group A and group D, is almost same. I mean, this study is whether you need to make the patient as inpatient or the one day surgery. So there is no significant difference. So for new beginner in doing transforaminal, it is okay to admit the patient a day in a surgery. We do not need to make the patient inpatient before a day before the surgery. Effect time of first embolization on recurrence of PLD. The journal is from China. This is a good journal. As we see, the group E, M, and L. E is means early, M mid middle, and L is late. I mean, E early is 3 to 24 hours after surgery mobilization, and middle is we have a 1 day bed rest and 2-3 day bed rest, and the group late is 3 day to 7 day bed rest before mobilization. And the result is the when the leg pain is almost the same, but the back pain it is increases in the early group. So it is better to make the patient has a bed rest for approximately 24 hours to prevent back pain due to early mobilization. And this is the journal. So we should make the patient little patient to do for ambulation. In my cases, this is my logbook of the fellowship endoscopic in Mahatma Gandhi Mission. Thanks to Dr. Malcolm Beston Disser and Dr. Satish Chandra Kure for teaching me. This is the case. This is all treated by PLD. This is just 43 here, but it is combined with operation in my hospital also. We have more 7 cases, but I not included here. This is the sample, the case. The female 39 years old with chronic back pain and sleep disturbances. In a traditional treatment, we just treat this patient with this condition. This is a chronic non-healing annular tear with a conservative treatment. But if we put the scope inside here and we take a view with the scope, we can see that there is an annular tear here and the trap fragment from the disc that irritate the dural. So it caused the patient to be radiculopathy. And if we treat the patient with open surgery, maybe we can treat this, but the collateral damage caused by our approach is getting more. So maybe we can reduce the leg pain, but the back pain become even more. The procedure of discogram before I'm doing transforaminal. I always do this kind of procedure in my patient, and I treat also with sometimes I give a trans intradiscal steroid injection. And this is the second case, male 53 years old, radicular pain to the right leg, unresponsive to conservative treatment for 6 months. This is the fragment, the central, but it is not large, it is grade 1 because it is not more than the facet joint. So I usually draw in the MRI of the patient with my spidol or my pen, and I draw the centimeter because I am afraid of getting penetrate the peritoneum, or sometimes in the low high level L2 or L3 I will penetrate the kidney. So I always draw this to measure. I never use 8 centimeters, 9 centimeters, 10 centimeters to the every level. I always measure every single patient. This is the central prolapse of the L45, and you can see here. I always draw this to see that my needle should land posterior to the vertebral body. It is okay. I will not penetrate the dura because there is a protrusion of the disc. So if I put here posterior to the vertebral body, I still touch the disc. And this is the procedure. You can see my working channel here. I am putting here, it is outside in technique. I put here and I try to drill the facet to make foraminoplasty, to make access so I can pick the disc herniation. And this I use intramedullary drill for ortho. I am still a ortho surgeon, so I still do trauma case. So I do intramedullary rimmer, and I drill here to the foramen to the patient. You can see in my hospital, this is rural hospital, so no complete equipment here, so we have to try to use other instrument. And as you can see here, This is the final picture of the clearance. I can clear everything here, and this is half in, half out. I can clear the dura, epidural here, under there is no fragment here, and the annulus. My teacher always told me that I should not clear all the annulus, so I can let the annulus to heal, not to take everything. I just do this surgery and local anesthesia and ask for the clinical sign or the complaint of the patient. If the patient said, doctor, my radicular pain is gone, so I stop the surgery. Sometimes I left some annulus here, not to cut everything, because I let the annulus to heal, and I will not make more instability here. And as you can see here, my CRISPR can open and bite everything here. This is after fat PLT transforaminal approaching, and this is the final pictures. See, okay. Sorry, my record video is broken in my hospital, so I have to record with my phone. And this is the patient, the third patient, mistake 26 patient with chronic back pain, radicular pain during walking. You can see the straight leg raising of the left. He tried to inhibit it because of pain, and you can see this. This is before surgery. He cannot walk without painkiller. So even I give tramadol and ketorolac, he still felt pain, and so he show him the radiating pain. And this is the X-ray. You can see a postural scoliosis pain, and this is a large central prolapse disc, and this is the slightly lefty side. This is the prolapse disc, and this is the position we make in our hospital here. And this is a line marking. I do this line marking by in the YouTube how to draw it. There is a first line, second line, and third line, and fourth line. And I always did I always do a discogram for this, and then I put the disc and try to land 25% in the posterior. And then this is the picture. I put also methylene, but make sure not to push to insert the dura, because it will cause a paraplegia. And this is the process that I grasp everything out, but and this is the clearance. I take the fragment here, and you can see here I clear the disc, and this is the final pictures. After I can see the nerve is can pulsate like this, I stop the surgery, and the patient said that, doctor, I have no pain, no reticulopathy, my reticular pain is gone. I stop the surgery. I am going to show you this bleeding. This is the only bleeding, so the bleeding of this procedure is very minimum. And this is the one day after the surgery, the SLR of the left and the right side, no inhibition. The patient can walk freely and happy. And this is the MRI pre-op PLT. I will compare to you that this is pre-op. My teacher said always do MRI post-op to evaluate whether how is your technique, it is improved or not. We cannot deny or state to the patient that we already operate you and we are success, but we have to evaluate ourselves. As you can see here, I successfully take the large disc here and here, and as you can see, there is still some fragment here, but since the patient it's okay, I do not clear everything here, because I'm afraid it will create instability. As you can see also here, the L4-5 disc is already black disc, so if I take more disc here, it will create more instability to this kind of patient, since this patient is only 26 years old. Is this the last case, the fourth case? Sorry, sir, I ask for more injury time, sir. This is the prolapse IV disc, lumbar 4-5, and I did a transforaminal approach here. Here I was afraid that I injured this I thought this is a dressing rod, maybe it is a root injury, but there is no tingling or radiating pain after the procedure. So I'm going to show you that even a good surgeon, senior master, our master may make a mistake. But in this patient, I think this is only a vessel because not nerve. So sometimes we do something that can injure to the patient. So this is the last picture I will show you. This I will always clear like this. I will not clear all the disc inside here, so because I think I will injure and cause more instability. As long as the patient has a pain-free and the patient is satisfied, I stop the surgery. Okay, this is the procedure. This is the procedure that I'm doing also interlaminar PSLT because I feel that I cannot clear the disc. So I convert to the PSLT also. Here I do interlaminar procedure is almost same. We open the flavum and then we clear everything until we can see the pulsating dura. And see, as you can see here, I do combine transforaminal and interlaminar. It is in the 40th case of my transforaminal. I have to combine both of them. And this is the result of pre-PLT and post-PLT. As you can see, the pre-PLT, you can see the prolapse disc in the central and the foraminal here. And 3 months post-PLT, the fragment is gone. You can see it. And here. So this patient has a pain relief at all condition. I mean, there is no complaint at all. So this is the pre and post 3 month post PSLT, PELT, I'm sorry. Okay, and this is my study. We still collecting the case. My operative duration, I'm going to tell you the truth that I'm still doing in 2 hours because I'm still new beginner. And most of them, I do transforaminal, and I just did one case of combination of transforaminal and interlaminar. Take-home message for beginner: endoscopic surgery have a steep learning curve. There is no one-do-it-all method. I mean, transforaminal, interlaminar, and combination. Learn from the endoscopic surgeon mentor will flatten the curve and keep on learning and improving yourself. Do not be discouraged from criticism and failure. Admit your failure. Never try to prove to anyone. You only need to prove it to yourself that you are competent. And this is my teacher who teach me a lot about endoscopic spine. When before I meet this guy, I even cannot put a scope. And now I can do 50 surgery. Thank you so much.
Adam, that was quite a long talk, but thank you so much. I think you're an encouragement to all newcomers. Your positivity, your attitude has always been very encouraging, and it has been my privilege to have been your teacher.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Someday I hope to learn from you. That is the way it should be. Now, I think we have ended today's session. We had a wonderful session with Xavier, Dan, Tamer, Tariq, sir, and Adam. Unfortunately, we missed out on Dr. Christoph Hofsetter because he had to attend another surgery. We will try and adjust him tomorrow. If any of you have any questions, please do ask them. Dr. Kavi, I would like your closing comments. And I would like to then say goodbye for today, and we meet tomorrow again at 11 o'clock India time to start our day 2. So Dr. Kavi, your closing statements, please.
Yeah, before we end up, I have one small question for Dan.
So we have a wonderful Christopher with us now.
Yeah, has he joined us now? Then we would love to listen to him.
Yes.
It's an honor. Dr. Christopher,
yes, will upgrade him.
Dr. Christoph, are you there with us?
I will upgrade him. Give me one second.
Please do. It'll be a pleasure to conclude with all our speakers.
Yeah, in the meantime, Dan, I wanted to ask you, what is the size of the endoscope you use for your thoracic disc surgery? The central channel.
Well, that's a good one. I've used 4.1 millimeter working channels, and I've also used some older scopes that have smaller than a 4 millimeter channel. Currently, my favorite scope has a 4.3 millimeter working channel. So I've found that the working channel is smaller than four. It's difficult to get a drill down there. It's difficult to clear the bony fragments as you're working if this channel is too small. So I've migrated away from the 4.1 up to 4.3. If I could get a bigger one, like the 4.7, I'd probably go for it. But 4.3 is primarily what I use now.
And one more question. What is the highest level of thoracic disc you have removed?
Probably T6-7.
With the same scope?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. That's good. Because I've gone up till T5. I've not ventured beyond that. I had the privilege of seeing one of our colleagues from South America. He had done a T3 level. That was amazing. But then I think he used a cervical scope because at T3 it would not be possible to use a lumbar scope.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I think T5, T6, fair enough. We can go with our lumbar scopes. This is definitely a message to all of our spine endoscopy enthusiasts that a regular scope, a regular transforaminal scope can be used up till the T5, T6 levels. The foramens are quite large and the approach is a little steep. Again, I will reiterate what Dan had shown and marked as the green corridor. Please go back, check the recording on YouTube. That is the safest way to enter, definitely. Enter, manipulate, mobilize, reach the cord, but do it very slowly, gently. Do it under local anesthesia. You don't need neuromonitoring. And there's always the pleasure of getting a large thoracic disc out.